The verse in Surah Al-Fatiha, اِحْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. How do we implement this with regards to the heart and the tablets?
اِحْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. We need this to show you the importance of al-hidayah. See, we're saying it 17 times a day. It doesn't mean that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a hidayah, you don't need the hidayah. That's why everybody, even if he's the best scholar on the earth, still he needs hidayah. Some of them, they said, اَهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. So to continue in our hidayah, اَهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. No, Ibn Taymiyyah said, Ibn Qayyim, he said, in every single move you do, you need hidayah. You are practicing, you are good, you are a righteous person, but you come to the musalla. Sitting here, argument happened. Now this is your turn. There is an action. Now you have to do something with your friend, your brother. You are talking about something. Get upset. So you need hidayah in every single move. Hidayah, it's not just, you know, become a Muslim now. Hidayah to implement whatever in Islam. So you need hidayah in that. Hidayah that you get the right ilm, not the wrong ilm. Hidayah, you know that in this situation you should do this, you don't do that. Hidayah to give you sabr to attend classes. Hidayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send you a good brother to deal with him. So what you need the hidayah in every single move you do in your life. اَهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. This is something you need it. You need it every day.
With regards to iman, iman in the heart.
Well, this is what if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the hidayah, it means it's open for anything. You go now to your house, you see your wife. You don't say, Allah, alhamdulillah, I have the hidayah. Allah guided me. I'm Muslim. I'm a good Muslim. You are going to face in every single minute, something. Your wife, she was a... Why you came late? Now, this is you ask the hidayah to deal, how to deal with this situation. You need hidayah in every single movement you do. If you want to do it according to Kitab and Sunnah, it's not just coming to the musalla and praying. Coming out, seeing somebody is walking. Next time, inshallah, give them right. This is, you need hidayah. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hidayah to give me anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, and the hidayah will affect your iman, affect your ilm, affect your in everything you need hidayah. In everything you need that. To keep that hidayah, you need hidayah. To implement whatever you know, you need hidayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you choose the correct kitab. This is hidayah. You ask and you sit with a good sheikh. This is hidayah. So hidayah, in everything hidayah you need it. And this will affect your iman, of course.
Now, what about the person who is all the time asking, but he's falling into sins or he's falling into innovation?
Wallahi, if he called, make dua, as we said in this, and make istighfar, and you have tawheed, if you are sincere, looking for the haqq, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bottom of your heart to guide you, why not? Even we said the mushrik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted from him. A mushrik, he will be changed to some wahid. The same thing for a mubtada. If he's looking for the truth, or he start, you know, some of them, they start, you know, saying, yeah, it's so. Because we use the haqq, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so and so. And you see, you know, Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, he changed his aqidah. He started following Imam Ahmad, the father of Imam al-Haramain. Juwaini, the father, he used to be Ash'ari, he would change. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the good place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with hikmah, he will give him that hidayah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make istighfar, and have a good tawheed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. لا يرضى لعباده الكفر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like, you know, kufra, somebody to have.